Okay, I feel like making another video. Another video about the Super Mario 64 rabbit hole. But what topic can I cover this time? I know, I'll research the 1995 build. And lucky for me, I happen to have a beta cartridge of Super Mario 64 right here. Let's put it in and see what the 1995 build has for us. On second thought, let's not research the 1995 build. My cartridge seems to be a little possessed. Builds. What can I talk about for this video? Wait, that's it! We can't talk about the 1995 build. But there is another build of Super Mario 64 that we can talk about. And lucky for us, it happens to have an article on the Mipshole Wiki. I'm talking about the Sombrero build. Yeah, that's right. This time around, I'm going to be reading the Mipshole Wiki article about the Sombrero build. And while I'm at it, I'll make this a double feature. Other than the Sombrero build, I'm also going to be talking about Bob-omb Village. Enjoy! Super Mario 64 Sombrero Build. Perhaps one of the earliest builds of Super Mario 64 known is the affectionately named Sombrero Build, named after the character who wears a large sombrero. This build was likely a testing build for the Ultra 64 hardware, and many of the models associated with the build can be found in the Nintendo 64 creation kits, such as the infamous Sombrero Man. And to the right, you can see a screenshot from the Sombrero build. Appearance. From the screenshot of the build, it can be seen that the build features much different landscaping to Super Mario 64. The ground is brown and uneven with many hills. There are three trees positioned around the island in the background as a simple picture of a cloudy sky. Mario has been replaced with a stock low-poly sombrero-wearing person with a red and white checkered shirt, and there are three Bob-ombs scattered around the island. Theorizing. There is no date associated with this build, but judging by how bare bones it is and how it hardly resembles the final game, it is likely a very early version of the game. It is unknown if this game predates the 1995 build, or actually is this build. Reports of the infamous build say that this game hardly resembles the Mario universe, which could line up with the Sombrero build. However, the Sombrero build seems to lack the castle. Many source the Sombrero build as the first iteration of Bob-omb Village, a supposedly removed level from Super Mario 64. This is evident by the Bob-ombs that appear to be present within this build. No semblance of a village can be seen within the screenshot. Bob-omb Village. Bob-omb Village is a supposedly unused area similar to Rainbow Village in Super Mario 64 that can reportedly be found in several personalized copies. As the name suggests, it's a village-like area connected to Bob-omb Battlefield and the Bob-ombs. It reportedly requires the player to shoot into a hidden warp in Bob-omb Battlefield with a cannon, usually in the skybox, or entering one of the broken paintings on the second floor of Princess Peach's castle. Bob-omb Village is also reportedly connected to the Child of Big Bob-omb. Description. Bob-omb Village is typically described as a grassy plain with several hills, houses, and other architecture, with other areas surrounding it, such as a cave, a castle or temple, a forest that reportedly houses a cabin, or even a sky area similar to Wing Mario Over the Rainbow that can be accessed with a cannon. There are reportedly Bob-omb buddies that appear, and even friendly Bob-ombs, though they typically still attack the player. There is also supposedly a statue that can appear with the appearance of Big Bob-omb, the Child of Big Bob-omb, or a totally unrelated statue, such as the one seen in the castle courtyard or the Toad Shrine. The enemies reported in this level obviously include Bob-ombs, though Goombas, Piranha Plants, and even a Chain Chomp have been reported, with enemies such as Booze and Scuttlebugs appearing in the cave or forest. While most reports say the buildings cannot be entered, some say they can, typically containing simple rooms you'd expect in whatever the building appears as. One of the most commonly reported buildings is a shop, which houses a power star, according to some. Others report a tower that must be traversed, a cabin off in the woods similar to the one reported in Big Boo's Forest, or a museum of some kind that reportedly holds several statues similar to the one reportedly outside. Missions. The most commonly reported star in Bob-omb Village is a red coin star, as it is typically not a full course. Other reports mention a boss fight in the castle area, usually against Big Bob-omb, though some reports mention the child of Big Bob-omb appearing instead. Yet others mention a star in the shop that must be bought with coins collected in the level, a star simply found by exploring the forest, traversing a tower in the village, finding a star in the sky area using the wing cap or some other flying ability, pressing a hidden switch, exploring the cave area, defeating enemies found in the level, or racing Koopa the Quick. This level has some of the most reported missions, likely due to the frequency it is located in personalized copies. Theorizing. It is believed that Bob-omb Village was originally Bob-omb Battlefield before the war started with Big Bob-omb, where the Bob-omb buddies and Bob-ombs lived in peace. However, it was ruined when Bowser gave the Big Bob-omb a power star, allowing them to take over. Alternatively, Bob-omb Village could just be a nearby area or on a different island, judging by how some report flying into a skybox of Bob-omb Battlefield and finding Bob-omb Village, as a skybox used is an ocean filled with several islands. Reports. Black Joysticks Documentation. This video by Black Joystick documenting Bob-omb Village begins in the outside area of Floor 2B, shown in the other video, A Closer Look at Floor 2B. They enter the level, which has the course number 2, with the only mission visible being the Child of King Bob-omb. Due to Super Mario 64 calling them Big Bob-omb, this has caused some to question the validity of this video. Notably, A Closer Look at Floor 2B, Bob-omb Village has the course number 1, with the first star collected titled Big Bob-omb's Invasion, with the second mission being Foot Race with Koopa the Quick, apparently the same as a regular Bob-omb Battlefield. What caused the change is unknown. The player falls into the level, which is relatively flat and blocky with square walls all around the entire level, starting with a lowered area with unused dancing flowers, Bob-omb buddies, and a house with Bob-ombs in front of them, with a bridge leading to the rest of the level. Similarly to Bob-omb Battlefield's starting area, the player talks to the Bob-omb buddy in front of them, who says,
"New visitor, welcome to Bob-omb Village, the only village known for its explosions. But this is not the best time for tourism, you see. There's this small bomb child who is proclaiming himself as Prince Bob-omb and is trying to steal the power star we sealed in the bomb shrine. Could you please take care of him? That would be nice, since the star is the only power source we have around here."
The grammatical errors in this dialogue imply that this is either faked or the level was scrapped before the dialogue could be refined. Notably, the capitalization of the phrase power source implies that there are other special power sources, potentially anomalous collectibles such as power moons. The player runs over to the bridge, hitting a yellow exclamation mark box, and collecting the coins from the box and under the bridge. They climb up the bridge, where a small graphical error can be seen in the fence at the edge of the upper area. Goombas and a Koopa can be spotted, as well as a flower patch with a red coin and a tree. The player fights the enemies, and as the camera turns, it reveals a square rock in the middle of the ground near a pyramid-shaped rock and an upwards line of coins the player collects. Then they run to the left, finding more Goombas and Bob-ombs and a Bob-omb buddy next to the entrance of a cave. After defeating two Goombas, they speak to the Bob-omb buddy.
"I've heard that there's a power star inside of this cave. The only problem is that it's the Chain Chomp's cave. Anyone who's ever come in has never, never came out. I'd rather not risk blowing up in there. Chain chomps are extremely dangerous creatures, you know.
The player then looks into the cave entrance before walking away, jumping up a raised piece of land to another part of the level with more Bob-ombs and Goombas, as well as a large panel of rock with a star marker on it, indicating a star could appear there, likely the 8 red coin star. The player fights some Goombas and walks over to a Bob-omb buddy next to a fountain with a red coin on top of it.
Ever since that no good Prince Bob-omb came around, the fountain was drained completely. How am I supposed to steal the coins people throw in to make wishes if there's no fountain to make wishes in the first place?
The player runs over to a Bob-omb buddy next to a tall building and interacts with them.
Hey there, amigo! Mi nombre es Bob Ernesto Calaza el Fifth. I'm el assistant of the guy that runs this hat store. He's known as Sombrero Amigo around here. He dreams of becoming the most successful hat businessman in El Mundo Entero. But I don't think that's an actual career. I could be wrong, but who knows?
The player runs to the upper left corner of this area, finding several flower patches and trees surrounding a ring of coins in a Bob-omb buddy. A red coin can be seen in the flower patch.
I like flowers. Do you like flowers too? Because I love flowers.
The player runs away and looks up, seeing the tower that has a sombrero on it, and a sign that says, Sombrero's Hat Emporia, as well as a floating island in the distance. The player runs towards a nearby path, with another line of coins and a group of Goombas next to a Bob-omb, with more indents in the land leading upwards. There is also a nearby ravine, where the cave would be, with two chain chomps inside, likely the chain chomps cave mentioned earlier by the Bob-omb buddy. The player jumps over to the top of the cave entrance where a purple exclamation mark switch can be seen. The player activates it, causing it to spawn boxes leading up to another part of the level, with the Bob-omb and what appears to be a cannon, likely used to reach the floating island seen earlier. The player jumps to the top of the level from the cannon, finding another set of Goombas in a castle-like area. The bomb shrine mentioned earlier. Next to the entrance is a Bob-omb buddy.
This is our legendary bomb shrine. We have our only power source here, which is a power star. But we've been in kind of a struggle since that small Prince Bob-omb came in and took it. And now he's big. I wish we didn't have to rely on that single star to live our happy lives. Electricity? What's that? Some sort of magical spell or something?
The player enters the bomb shrine and is warped into a sub-area. It is a large, vast area with a carpeted path leading through a void with distant walls seemingly stretching forever, with a pink line on one side of the carpet and a black line on the other, likely representing Bob-ombs and Bob-omb buddies. Notably, this area has unique music not heard anywhere else. They walk forwards towards a raised platform with a design of a half-Bob-omb, half-Bob-omb buddy in the center of the carpet, where the child of Big Bob-omb can be seen, standing in front of a pillar with the display case on top, likely meant to house the power star. Notably, the texture appears to be white instead of black, with a red mustache and paper crown, potentially meant to differentiate them from Big Bob-omb, or simply an error from a filter on the video.
Aha! Are you here to reclaim that village's precious power star? That's just fine, then. But you're going to have to go through I, Prince Bob-omb, son of King Bob-omb. No, this is not a paper crown. It's legitimate. What? No, my stash is not fake either. It's legitimate too.
A fight then begins that plays out like the regular Big Bob-omb boss battle. The player eventually defeats the Prince Bob-omb.
What? What? Can it be that a pipsqueak like you has defeated the Bob-omb prince? It's not fair. You might be fast enough to ground me, but you'll have to pick up the pace if you want to take King Bowser by the tail. What? You've already done it twice? How come I haven't heard about this yet? Oh man, Dad's gonna be so disappointed on me when he finds out about this. If you want to see me again, select the star from the menu.
Note the similarities to the dialogue at the end of the Big Bob-omb boss fight, and the mention of the player defeating Bowser twice, meaning in this copy, Floor 2B was to be explored after clearing the basement. Prince Bob-omb explodes into a power star, which lands on top of the display case. The player collects it, and the video ends. Greenio's documentation. In Greenio's video, Beta Bob-omb Battlefield, the player, apparently at Space World 1995, explores an early version of Bob-omb Battlefield, as the name suggests. Towards the end of the video, however, they find a hole in the ground that leads to a sub-area that appears to be a version of Bob-omb Village. The sub-area begins with the player falling into a rocky, cave-like room, with the light coming down from above, before running forwards and down a slope to an area with several houses resembling those of Wet Dry World and Bob-ombs that attack the player. Notably, the climbable stalagmites on the ground appear to act the same as trees. The player climbs one and gets on top of a house where a line of coins resides, which they collect. They jump towards a church building that appears to be exactly the one from Wet Dry World, even with the staircase leading up to it. There, they find a yellow Bob-omb buddy.
The entire town's gone mad! Try to flood the village and cool the villagers down!
The player looks around, seeing a platform above the town again, similar to the one in Wet Dry World. The player jumps on top of the church, which leads to several floating platforms they then traverse, finding a crystal tap. They move around for a second, revealing the other platform holds the yellow cap switch. The player touches the crystal tap, flooding the entire area. They swim towards the yellow cap switch before pressing it, which causes the game to crash as the video ends. Hey, did you like this video? If you did, then I got good news for you. I have a lot of videos like this one, an entire playlist for you to listen to if you so choose. And while you're at it, I also have a blog that I want you to look at. The link is in the description. Enjoy the playlist, and enjoy my blog. Thank you very much.